Hello, in this video, we will cover the basics of database. So why do we need a database? Data is all around us. For example, you might have all your contacts and their phone numbers on your phone. Your emails are stored in your email app. Your photographs are there on Instagram. Videos are on YouTube. You get the picture. If you think you have a problem managing your data, think of some large companies like Google, Facebook, or any large corporation or bank. Imagine where they are storing all their user data, mails, messages, photos, videos, billing, vendor information, etc. And we as their customers want our data ASAP. All of these companies have databases. A database is nothing but a collection of data or information that is organized in such a way that it can be easily accessed, managed, and updated. And DBMS or Database Management System is a software that handles the storage, retrieval, and updation of data in a computer system. Some popular DBMS are MySQL, SQL Server, Oracle, etc.
Why can't we use our old file processing system?
File processing system has disadvantages like data redundancy, data inconsistency, unshareable data, unstandardized data, insecure data, etc.
Wait, what?
Okay, let's understand each of them one by one. Data redundancy means duplication of data. Non-database systems maintain separate copy of data for each application. This duplication of data may lead to inconsistency or incorrect data at times. For example, DBMS stores all data at one place and all the application programs that require this data can refer to the same central place. This centralization makes sure that data remains consistent and secure. Data redundancy leads to data inconsistency. Multiple mismatching copies of same data is known as data inconsistency. When the redundancy is not controlled, there may be occasions when the two entries about the same data do not agree. At such times, the database is said to be inconsistent. An inconsistent database will provide incorrect or conflicting information. Next comes sharing. DBMS makes sure that not only the existing applications can share the data in the database, but also that new applications can be developed to operate against the same stored data. There may be certain standards laid by the company, industry standards, or national international standards which need to be followed. DBMS can ensure that all of the data follow the standard for storage and retrieval. The data information of an organization individual must be kept secure and private. DBMS ensures data security and privacy by ensuring that the only means of access to the database is through the proper channel, and also by carrying out authorization check whenever access to sensitive data is attempted. There are different types of databases. They include hierarchical, network, object-oriented, and relational database. We will cover relational database here. When the data is stored in multiple tables that are linked via common field, then such a database is called relational database. A table is data set that is organized into rows and columns. A row is also called as record, which represents one complete unit of information. Column is also called as field, which contains one type of information. It is the smallest unit of named data. It may consist of any number of bits or bytes. Normally, a table has one column or field which uniquely identifies the record of the table. This field is called the primary key. A foreign key is a field that references the primary key of another table. Now that you have your data in databases, how do you work with it? Most large companies have DBA or Database Administrator, who is responsible for managing and maintaining the DBMS. They use SQL or Structured Query Language, which helps you to create, access, and manipulate databases. You typically write queries in English-like language to perform any of these tasks. Most DBMS display forms, which is an interface in user-specified layout that allows user to view, enter, change, data directly in the table. The data is then used to present as reports to senior management. It is a formal, presentable, printed document that lists data in a formatted manner.